Blackstone presents Burgundy, The Commentators, a collection of episodes from I'll Drink to That, hosted and produced by Levi Dalton.
I'm Levi Dalton, and this is I'll Drink to That, where we get behind the scenes of the wine business. When it comes to Burgundy Crus, something that you will hear vignerons say is that one area of Volnay differs from another area of Volnay. Or sometimes they say this about Vaune, or Chambord, or Mauri-Saint-Denis. It is said about a lot of different particular villages. There is the idea that the character of the crus in one part of a particular village is different from those found in other parts of that same village. This is one reason why you hear vigneron talking about blending together the wine of several different crus situated within a single village to achieve a true sense of village character in the wine from that village. Benjamin Leroux mentions doing this for his village wine in his interview, for instance. But actually, when you think about it, it can seem a bit odd that two crus from the same village would give a very different character from one another, and that a third crew in that same village might be entirely different from the first two. It can seem odd because the village names are what are used to indicate the areas on many Burgundy maps and many Burgundy labels. And we think of Volnay as a unit containing crews that have a character that is Volnay-like. But the question is, should we perceive it that way? Should the village names be the distinguishing feature in how we understand Burgundy? Françoise Vanier, a geologist who has been studying the crus of Burgundy for two decades now, has some answers to these questions, and she is the guest on today's program. To better follow along with what Françoise says, a map of Burgundy, a standard village-centered map of Burgundy, may be a helpful thing to have in front of you. And before we get to her interview, we should recall how the geology of France came to be and how the Côte d'Or as we know it was formed. Geologist Brenna Quigley explained that process in episode 463 of I'll Drink to That.
So the history of the geology of France starts over 300 million years ago. Most people know that Pangaea was a supercontinent that existed in the past. But what a lot of people don't know is that there are actually several different supercontinents in the history of the Earth. So Pangaea was just the most recent. And that makes sense if you think about, you know, continents are basically moving around a sphere. So if they continue moving for billions of years, they're going to crash into each other, and then eventually they're going to start moving apart, and then they'll crash into each other again. So basically, the oldest rocks in France, the Massif Central and the Massif Armorican, are ancient mountain ranges that were formed by the assembly of Pangaea. So before Pangaea existed as a supercontinent, it was separate continents that all kind of came together during these, you know, relatively dramatic continental collisions and formed these really ancient mountain ranges. Sometime after 300 million years ago, Pangaea started to break apart. And so now we're getting into the formation of the Paris Basin. So the Paris Basin is when we talk about, you know, Champagne, Chablis, Sancerre are all a part of the Paris Basin. They formed during the Jurassic period, so around 200 million years ago. And it's not a coincidence that, you know, whenever you see little recreations, drawings of dinosaur times, that it always looked really kind of hot and muggy and tropical. And that's because during this time, the temperature of the Earth was actually higher. It was a really warm time in Earth's history. And there were no glaciers at the poles, so sea level was really high. So if you imagine Pangaea started breaking apart, and all of that land that just newly separated got flooded with water. And it was in these massive amounts of really shallow, warm waters that we started getting the formation of limestone. And this is why the Jurassic period in time is usually associated with limestone, is because a huge amount of the Earth's continents were actually.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.